first test, and he gave me that first test back, and it was 100. That second test came back, and it was 100, and I said, you know what? This kid's listening. He's not only listening, but he's taking it all in. So we never had that discussion again, did we? And as I got to know him better, and as we got to sit in class together, he would come up, and especially in science, science is definitely his passion. And we would start talking about things, and we talked about, like, when we got to the volcano. It was, Ms. Kinder, can I tell you about magma? And he would stand up, and he would tell us all about magma. And we talked about natural resources, and he'd pop up, and he'd tell him about going to his grandparents' house in Mississippi. And when we did the science projects, which he was all into, he wanted to go watch the older kids. And he wanted to go see what they were doing and watch them do their projects and stuff. And he was all about definitely going into space. So you definitely, this one right here, along with probably a Lennon, will be beside him, will be my first man in Mars. So you have First Man in Mars Award, that one. You definitely have my Science Award, because that's what he piped up the most. He loves science. Hang on, you have my Future Scientist Award. Here's to Caleb. And on top of that, he's patriotic. When we talked about Veterans Day, his love of the military, he always did in the weapons, in the military, in the soldiers. He drew towns. Talked about it, explained to me where each thing was, and all that. So you definitely, my USA, Mississippi State, patriotic award, buddy. Good job. Patriotic award. Good job, buddy.
So, Eli, to me, if I was going to have a most successful year at school yet award, he would get it. Bar none, he has soared this year. The first thing that I love, reading is my favorite thing. To me, if you can read and comprehend, you can do anything in this life. And this boy, he's reading some serious books. And some of the kids will come back and I'll be like, are you sure you read that book? But you can tell he read it, because he's like, no, I'm on the part where this is happening. I can't wait to get home and read the next chapter. You know, he's so excited. Not only that, but in other content areas, when we're studying science or history or something like that, he'll be like, we have this book at home on this, and I was reading about this, this, and this. So he reads not just fiction books. He reads about content things. He just will pick up something. If there's words on the page, he will read them. So you're getting my Ravenous Reader Award. The next one I'm going to give him is problem solving. I can't wait till he takes the OLSAT test in a year or two. He's going to blow it out of the water. Those critical thinking books, most of the kids are like, oh, because they're just weird. Problems, puzzles, you know, puzzles, things like this. He's like, can I do more puzzles? Can I solve some more problems? And he really calculates. He approaches things from outside of the box. He's going to be one to watch. Problem solver. And the other thing, I had to laugh when I saw this award, because you know they have, you buy Nobel awards and you kind of like, okay, what child will that be? Well, this is a Mathlete Award. And if you know Eli has always done math at a snail's pace, okay? I mean, in kindergarten, you're like, Eli, do you want to go to first grade? I mean, it was just like pulling teeth to get him to do his math. Well, this year, how far are you into your fifth grade math book already?
I finished the first chapter.
He's finished the first chapter of his fifth grade math book already. So he has completed his curriculum and is into next year's curriculum already. So he is getting my Mathlete Award. I'm really proud of him.